It's not like it's always a perfect process where it's just like profit, 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 profit. Sometimes in slower markets, or you know, when you're new, rich, and spoiled, now you have the ability to test new stuff. Like Jack, during your real hot streak, you were taking like 20, 30, 40 positions in like low price swings that you could just park money in. When you didn't have a lot of money, you weren't able to do that. I get some questions. People are like, oh, I want to trade like Jack. And I'm like, you don't have the money to trade like Jack. So, you know, recognize your new status allows you more testing. So I understand that you want to make like a nice linear amount of profits, but sometimes like you have to go back into research and development mode. Like every successful company, when they're having record profits, they don't just sit on their money. They invest 20, 30% of their money, 10% of their money, whatever, into research and development. Yo, what up?
Yo. Hey.
How's it going?
It's shitty.
Why? You shorting these NFT plays and getting destroyed?
No, I'm long them. That's the only ones I'm making money on.
Why are you trading anything else?
Because I'm a degenerate.
Dude, just trade NFTs. That's the hottest thing right now.
I got INPFF and MDMFSF for like 50% discounts.
Those are tough. I don't like these like F tickers, like IPNFF. Are you still holding that, Jack?
Yeah.
From 21?
Yeah. I only have 50,000 shares.
That's what I'm saying. I got the same. I'm doing the same thing.
Maybe. I don't know. It's too choppy. I couldn't even hold like UAMM, but I'm long CWRK overnight. That's cool. And my first.
You've been crushing it with these breaking news spikers. I'm not good at these.
Dude, it's LRDC, MDMP. Today you saw NRPI.
Every single day there's one. I'm going to be in breaking news tomorrow because I have nothing to do.
Fantastic. That's what you should be. I don't know why you're not using it. You're too busy getting haircuts. Look at you, Mr. Jack Brand New. You get a haircut?
Yeah, you need one now too.
I know. One day, when I have time. Some of us actually work. We're not just rich, spoiled millionaires. Look cool, man. You earned it. Take some time off. Look at how tan you are. Look, you're like orange. Like it's beautiful. You've been chilling on the beach forever.
I think it's just my lighting. I'm definitely
Just accept it. It's fine.
You're tan.
How's your golf game? Are you a scratch golfer now? Can you compete with Monaco?
No, it's still cold in New Hampshire. I don't even think they've opened the courses yet.
I thought that you invested in that that indoor golf course that you were talking about.
Indoor golf course.
I'm just messing with you. You rich, spoiled millionaire. You lose like your sense of humor too. What the hell? You don't even know who you are.
Serious.
Look at your teeth. Did you get like all your teeth done? You went to the dentist now too? You're just like taking care of everything?
I actually am starting to like. I went to the grocery store.
Yeah.
I bought some Listerine for my gums. So.
I'm proud of you. You have to counter all the Doritos.
You see that?
That's good. I'm proud of you.
Fresh, baby.
Wait, but that's unopened. You haven't even used it yet.
I just bought it like 30 minutes ago.
During the market is open and you're going out buying Listerine? Are you insane?
I think it's better than buying stocks.
Oh my God. You realize like the stimulus money is back. Did you see the GIF that I posted, like Stimmy? Stimmy!
No, people are getting their money. I'm just having trouble right now. Like, I don't know. Like, I don't know. It kind of changed. I feel like I don't know what I'm doing.
Because you're rich now. Now you have. Before you was like, you know, it was like Rocky and Rocky 2, but now it's like Rocky 3 and 4, where you're the champ of the world. You're living in the big mansion, and now you've lost. You know. Like what made you so good, right? It's the eye of the tiger. You got to fight just to keep it alive. Don't lose a grip on the dreams of the past.
Jack has no idea what you're saying.
No, it makes sense though. It makes sense
because you know that song. Yeah. Come on.
Yeah, I know that. Rocky, like, he was younger and he was getting after it. You must
fight just to keep it alive. It's the eye of the tiger. It's the beat of the fight. Rising up to the challenge of your rival. And the last known survivor starts spreading the light. And he's back in.
I know it. I know some of it.
Sing it.
I was.
I didn't hear you.
Yeah, because you're too loud. You gotta be.
This is karaoke time, man. We're chilling. This is karaoke. Look at you. You're already drinking your scissor. You're getting ready.
Mm-hmm. Ready to go.
What did you drink? Are you drinking some orange juice?
No, I'm being a bad boy right now. I'm having some Coke vanilla.
Oh, I also bought that
at the store. I never drink soda.
Show the Doritos.
The Doritos are in the cabinet. That's like a walk.
Damn.
Like, I got to get up and, like, go get those, you know? Like, that's too much.
Get yourself, like, a little motorized vehicle. You're rich now. You should have these little toys.
Mm-hmm. Get that suitcase with wheels on it.
Get, like, a little electronic robot waiter thing. It's, like, made by some Japanese company.
How are those vacuums that are...
The Roombas.
Yeah, are those any good? Does anyone... You guys have those?
I was looking to buy one.
I think my parents have videos one. Where like you put like little cats on them or like babies or whatever, and they're like, "Wee!" You guys aren't killing it right now?
No.
Nope.
I'm gonna have my first red week since September.
Wow. I'm up. I'm up like not even 20,000 on the week.
What's going on? This is I haven't talked to you guys to keep you on track. Do you not see OCG? Do you not see IMTE? Do you not see MDRM? Do you not see TSNPD? How are you not like crushing it on TSNPD? Did you not see that
squeeze? TSNPD is my only win today.
TSNPD, I was short, and then I covered at 290, and then I walked, or I covered some at 250.
And then you went to go get your Listerine. I hope you appreciate that Listerine. It's your $1,000, $10,000 Listerine.
It is.
You guys got to adapt. You can't, like, go watch. I'm giving you homework to watch, like, Rocky 3 and 4. It's not fun what happens to him when he's the champ.
I got to step it up. I know it.
Have you seen Rocky 3 and 4?
No, I've only seen the first and second.
Correct, round. Because that's when he has like the fight. But then 3 and 4, he's getting his ass kicked because he doesn't know how to deal with
it. Which one does he like train? Like, doesn't he train somebody in one? Or is that
Creed? That's Creed.
Well, no, but he trains Tommy Morrison too, who like turns around and screws him. But like, the point is that he lost the fire that made him so great in the beginning. And I see that with you, you know, your skin is turning orange and, you know, you're just radioactive.
No, I'm trying to figure out though, like, is it the market that has changed or am I just being lazy?
No, it's you. It's 100% you. So, I'm crushing it.
So many people Kyle and Matt are also struggling.
They're all rich and lazy too. You guys are all rich and lazy right now. You were doing so well. You're on the upward arc. You were riding the VWAP. Now you're under the VWAP and you can't get above. The VWAP is pushing you down below. You're literally, I know this sounds crazy, but if you look at your profit charts, you can probably determine a VWAP, right? Like volume weighted average profit. And you're under your VWAP lines. And now you're like, now you understand why the VWAP matters. Like it's a momentum indicator. You're under the VWAP.
I mean, I'm still at my highs, though. You think VWAP's over the highs?
Because it's your volume-weighted average profit. It's not even volume-weighted. It should be like a DWAP, your dollar-weighted average profit. You're below your DWAP.
We should make that a tool on Profitly.
This literally is, we're creating this right now. This is the idea. You have to watch out for your DWAP. By the way, anybody taking this seriously, I am totally joking. It is amazing that these guys are still doing well. I'm just also trying to push them. And I think there might actually be something to this DWAP idea. What do you think, Monaco? This is your indicator.
I just wrote, that's the title of the episode. I just wrote it down.
What is the DWAP? Like, I really think that, you know, the VWAP, in case you don't know, volume weighted average price. So like, it's a momentum indicator and momentum stocks need to stay above the VWAP. If they go below, it's tough to get the momentum back. These three guys all making millions of dollars for the first time in their lives, not knowing how to deal with it. And now, frankly, the market has changed a little bit. And these guys have changed. Look at Matt Monaco. Look, he's got like precious art behind him. He's invested in art. He's buying NFTs.
I decorated my apartment finally. I had to throw something up.
Dude, I know. You have time. You're going shopping. Like, you know, I invite you out. You're like, I don't know. I might have to go to Bed Bath & Beyond. I don't know if I'm going to have time to go out. Like, I'm busy spending my money. Look at Kyle. He's got the art. He's got the crypto art behind him.
Oh, wait. The best one of all.
Yeah, you got a cooler one, I think. Yeah.
Look at this.
He's got new art. Is that a new snowboard too? You're cashing in. You guys are all fucking Rocky 3 and 4.
I'm gonna need a refresher.
You need to get back to your roots. First of all, let's talk about this, because today, I don't know if you guys know this, but there's a new millionaire. He just surprised me today. We can't talk about who it is publicly yet, because it's a complex story, but literally just got surprised today. There's a new millionaire, which is pretty awesome.
Wow.
And he's at 1.3 million. And it's pretty cool. Like he totally surprised me with his son today. And it was a beautiful moment. I'm popping out millionaires left and right, like a dog in heat. It's crazy.
That's incredible.
Even though, let's never forget, 90% of traders lose. And it's because of so many reasons, but for Jack, Kyle, and Matt, they get too cocky. They get too comfortable. They lose the fire.
I think the market changed, but I will say I have failed to adapt. One thing that came up that I thought of was maybe daylight savings change time. I know it's only an hour, but for whatever reason, I feel like crap every day. I have felt like awful. I've woken up like just tired as hell. And that's not the only reason. Like, that's not like, oh, I'm blaming time, but like, I don't feel alert at all.
Too many times it happens too fast. You trade your passion for glory. Don't lose a grip on the dreams of the past. You have to fight just to keep them alive. This song is speaking to you guys. I know we probably can't play it because of like, you know, international copyright laws. But everyone should literally listen to this song. This defines exactly what's happening to you. Oh, daylight savings. Oh, I feel like crap. Shut up. Shut up, you baby. Stop living on the West Coast. Did you ever think of that? Did you ever think why I have so few successful students living on the West Coast? Because it sucks.
I made it. I did it.
No. This is the problem. You see, you think you're successful. You don't realize how behind you are.
I got much more to go. That's for sure.
No, you think you're already successful. You're like, look at me. I already did it.
I got many more.
I want you to return your art, return that snowboard, get rid of everything, get back to the basics. You need to go to Russia to train in the forests of Siberia.
That's where I started the challenge in?
You have to go to a place lower than where you started the challenge, because now you have to demote yourself. You've already promoted yourself too much. Now you need to go like, literally, you need to, I don't know what's like jail for vegetarians. Like you need to go trade from a steakhouse or something and see how it feels and be like, God, I hate this. When you make your next million, then you can get out of the steakhouse and trade from a place that you want to be.
All right.
I think it's Matt's time to get ripped on. Matt, what? Now it's Matt's time. Matt's turn to get ripped on.
This is all of you guys. All of you have lost your passion.
No, you got to rip on Matt next, though. You've gone from me to Kyle. Now it's Matt's time to shine.
I ripped on Matt's new art collection already.
That wasn't enough. We need a solid. We need like 2 minutes of it.
He's not losing as much as you guys. I'm sorry that he's more successful than you.
I'm not losing.
You're below your DWAP. You're losing.
Mm-hmm.
20,000 in a week? What have you even learned all of these new skills for if you're not going to utilize them?
20,000.
You literally learned all this stuff and you're like, no, I'm just not going to do it. I'm going to go in the middle of the day and get some Listerine. Like, what? Who are you? You told me a story. Now that your four-part marathon episode is live, now you can be a different person. You were like, I'm not going to go in the middle of the training day. I have mono. I have strep throat. I should go to the doctor, but I'm waiting till the market is closed. Now the market is open and you're like, let's go to the grocery store. I don't have mono. I don't have strep. I've already made millions of dollars. Why not just get some Listerine in the middle of the day, even though you can literally use apps to have someone bring it to you. You can call up Postmates, type in Listerine, pay that person $5 and bring it to you so that you don't miss the market action.
Yeah, but this is a special gum therapy Listerine with
Did you get your hair cut during market hours too? Were you talking to the barber like, hey, how's it going, Joe? Oh, the market's open. I'm trying not to look because I'm just spoiled, rich, and lazy. What?
The haircut was on the weekends.
Okay, good. So you haven't totally lost it.
Mm-mm. But yeah, no, totally. I've just, like you said, that just brings me back to a few months ago, like mono and strep. And I was like, you know, screw this. Like, I'm just going to keep grinding. But now, like, I'm just, no,
and
take
you
me
hear
seriously.
Kyle too, when I was like, you know, no one is successful on the West Coast. And he's like, look at me. Like, picture Kyle saying that a few months ago before he made a million. He never would have said that. I visited him on the West Coast. He was like, no, I got to keep going, keep going. Now you guys think that like $1 million is the end all. Wait till you get your tax bill, okay? Let's rip on that for a second. Because after you pay your taxes, you ain't millionaires anymore.
Mm-hmm. Valid.
You guys are supposed to inspire the younger generation. What's going on?
It's a little, I will say, another thing, another point. Only reason why I'm red is because I had two unfortunate trades. And without those trades, I would be green. So,
red or green, you're below your DWAP. If you're not making 50 or 100 grand in a week, like, I understand, literally. Look, you guys have earned it. Take some time off. Enjoy it. Smell the roses, get spoiled, stay in the tanning bed too long like Jack did. Whatever you want to do, that's fine. But when there's so many opportunities right now, you guys say, oh, the market has changed. The market hasn't changed that much. You have changed that much. So I encourage you to go talk to like your childhood friends, like people who can like ground you again so that you can get out of this funk. Matt Monaco should be talking with his friend Mike more often, right? Mike was the guy who introduced him to trading, but Mike was too lazy. He didn't succeed. Look at Matt Monaco's vein popping out. Look at his head. Look at that.
Harry
Get
Potter
in touch with
shit.
Mike again. Learn from Vincent. The lazy. Learn from the people who didn't make it. And then maybe that'll motivate you and you'll be like, I see what Mike did wrong. Mike, it was good catching up to you. I appreciate how unsuccessful you are. So I never want to be like that. So see you later. But you first have to go back to him. Where's Mike at, Matt?
He's still in upstate New York.
You must go to upstate New York. I'm going to pay for your flight. Go back to your childhood home where it's freezing, where it's miserable, where the food sucks. And you need to remember where you came from.
All right.
Doesn't know what to say.
That's it. Come on, Mono. You gotta fight back a little bit, but then ultimately
there's no fighting. You guys know that I'm right. Like the market
yeah,
has.
Yeah, but you gotta give him a little bit of a hard time, Matt. You can't just say all right. You gotta be
We're getting 100, 200, 300, 500% winners in a day. And you guys are like, I don't see anything. What?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like that's new. There was definitely a slower period though. And that
there was not this week. Not this week.
It was like kind of today was like, it really started heating up.
Yeah. And
yesterday
how much
a little bit, but
today?
Monday was slow.
How much did you guys make today?
13,000.
Yeah, that's
seven,
crap.
Actually, no, like 7,000.
Those are Sykes numbers. That's crap. I don't know if you saw it. I was literally buying UAMM on my webinar. I tried to add, I put in the wrong tick, put in the wrong amount. I got it at the wrong price. It started failing. I cut losses. I lost like $1,000 like a schmuck. And yet, that's how I'm trading. That's how you guys are trading.
So how are we getting back on track, boys?
I don't know. We're unrealized profits on my swings are doing quite well. I can lock in some of my swing trades and be up very nicely, like over like 50 or 60 on the week.
Okay.
But I want to trade the plan. I don't want to trade my P&L. So we're
holding. I appreciate that. I didn't know about those. So you're not as lost. You don't have to go to the steakhouse. Maybe just go to like a Taco Bell where it's still kind of like you don't know what's in the food there. It could be vegetables. It could be meat. I mean, that's still probably not a good place for vegetarians to go.
Yeah. So I'm partly on track. And just I think something I know for me, my personal strong suit is usually longing some of these OTC runners into the close. And some of them just have kept going and going and going and going. So by the time the close comes around, I don't feel comfortable chasing.
That's one thing different for me. So I'm also scared of the OTCs overnight because we've seen promoters, we've seen stocks getting halted. So I understand how that's a little more difficult, but morning spikers, you guys have no excuse. Did you guys catch any LRDC or MDMP?
Nope. No. I just have, I would say, like, I was a lot more late. Like, I had more time to think about my plan. I had more time to size in. I had, you know, these plans the night before, and I was taking a lot of daily chart trades, a lot of breakouts, a lot of first green days, a lot of first red days, and, like, sticking to my edge. But now the market is shifting into breaking news plays, you know, morning spikers, like VDRM yesterday, ICBU today. And then the breaking news plays as well. And I think just being a little bit more relaxed, I wasn't adapting quick enough to taking some of these plays, but those have definitely been the best winners. And those could have paid all really nicely if I just bought a few morning spikes, a few breaking news plays. I mean, they went up multiple hundreds of percent, and that's kind of where I've missed. I've continued to trade the edge that I traded the last 3 months. That's really not paying out as big anymore. Just because of the SEC halts and all these things that are kind of going on. So the game's changing a little bit. But as we talk here, like I'm realizing how I have to adapt and just kind of like playing the scenarios through my head. So I feel like I'm going to be fresher next week and kind of have a better idea of how I want to attack.
FYI, you don't have to wait until next week to adapt. Like, we're filming this in the middle of the week. This isn't Friday, in case you didn't know, you newly rich person.
Yeah, but I'm going to start small just to get a feel for it, you know? But fully, like, adapt next week and just kind of see what's going on.
Good. Start adapting. Don't be afraid. Also, when you guys have all this money now, you can, like, test new strategies. Now you have the money. So it's not like it's always a perfect process where it's just like profit, 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 profit. Sometimes in slower markets, or, you know, when you're new, rich and spoiled, now you have the ability to test new stuff. Like Jack, during your real hot streak, you were taking like 20, 30, 40 positions in like low price swings that you could just park money in. When you didn't have a lot of money, you weren't able to do that. I get some questions. People are like, oh, I want to trade like Jack. And I'm like, you don't have the money to trade like Jack. So, you know, recognize your new status allows you more testing. So I understand that you want to make like a nice linear amount of profits, but sometimes like you have to go back into research and development mode. Like every successful company, when they're having record profits, they don't just sit on their money. They invest 20, 30% of their money, 10% of their money, whatever, into research and development. And the research and development costs money for 1 month, 2 months, 6 months, 1 year, 5 years, whatever, when you're developing something new, but then it pays off later on. So I would encourage you guys to try new stuff. Everyone watching at home, do not try new stuff because you don't have the money. You haven't earned this right to research and develop. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. No, totally.
You know, that's how like top companies, frankly, can outperform smaller companies, because smaller companies have to invest all their resources into like one or two technologies that don't have many options. They're trying their best to scrape by and survive. But big companies can either buy the small company if they can't figure it out themselves, or they can invest in research and development and, you know, buy basically their future, invest in their future. So it's very similar with trading and traders. You have to start to invest in different strategies, even if they're not going to pay off right away. going to the grocery store and buying Listerine during market hours is not a strategy. That's a cop-out.
No, you're totally right. I just wasn't feeling it today. I wasn't feeling it yesterday. I wasn't feeling it the day before. Took some time off last week as well. And it's just being lazy.
I appreciate you taking time off. You know, you pushed yourself past the point of anything, and now you're literally glowing orange. Like it's like Dr. Manhattan-esque, except, you know, he was blue. But
well, yeah, I mean, I definitely didn't get haircuts, didn't really go outside at all, didn't do anything. So like now it's like going outside a little, getting some haircuts. So it's nice to, you know, change it up a little bit.
But it's nice to live a little, but yeah. Your homework is to watch the Rocky sequels. They're not fun. You're not going to like what happens to the character, but that's basically you.
Mm-hmm. No, I'm definitely going to watch that probably this weekend.
And you need to get it back, you know, get back to your roots. Like if the market wasn't hot, I would say, hey, go enjoy yourselves. You've earned it. But the market is hot. The new stimulus checks are literally getting delivered right now. People are literally putting their money into Robinhood accounts, buying whatever crap they want. And that's what's spiking these things 100, 200, 500, 1,000%. So right now is a very unique time. We're not going to probably have another round of stimulus checks. This will probably hopefully never happen again. Or even if it does, it'll be several years or several decades from now. So while it's happening right now, you capitalize. When the people, and again, I wouldn't, if I was just getting stimulus checks, I would never put in that into a brokerage account. I don't think that's a good idea, but people are probably going to do it. 6 months from now, 12 months from now, when anybody who has any stimulus money left will probably lose it trading, since 90% of traders lose, the markets probably will not be as hot 6, 12, 18 months from now. So this is the time to push it. Get a haircut 12 months from now, you know?
That's exactly the dreads.
No, I'm just saying push it while it's here. By all means, take your time. Don't lose. I mean, you guys are at least still getting used to like this newfound money. You know, don't get into a useless Twitter battle with somebody with like 10 followers like Matt Monaco now does for fun, you know, which just wastes time. You know, and he's like basically trying to bide his time. Like, should I get into Twitter battles or should I buy art? What should I do with my time now that I'm so rich?
I tried to help him. I was just trying to be a good guy.
No, you have to be cruel to be kind, okay? Some people are helpless.
He was definitely helpless. After about the 10th message, I was like, guy, cut my losses.
Tell them what you should have done is been like, look, I created this 30-day boot camp right before my big run. You can see my mindset. You can see the strategy. I didn't make 1.6 million% due to any one play. He literally thinks that you put your money into the market and now it's succeeded so much, and that's why you think that you're successful. You think that you're like one of these BS-free chat room people who just holds and hopes and then comes to the realization when CCIV crashes that you know shit. You didn't do that. You made thousands and thousands of little trades. That's all you had to say.
I'm learning. There we go. Now, next time, it'll just be one quick message. Just stop it. You know?
Just link the 30-day bootcamp. Everyone should use the 30-day bootcamp. Everyone should use Stocks to Trade Breaking News. Jack, you're going to use Stocks to Trade Breaking News tomorrow?
I'll be in there looking for hot news. So why don't we get a little educational? What kind of news should I be looking for?
So I created a free holiday guide. If you click the link below, we're going to link the free holiday guide. It's all about how to use Stocks to Trade Breaking News. I dressed as freaking Santa as I did the holiday guide.
I had an elf hat too. I was in that.
You had the elf hat. But the news is whatever is working. Like, you know, years ago, I would never trade oil plays, but now LRDC, DVFI. Did you trade DVFI, Jack? That's your kind of a play.
Nope.
DVFI.
I don't even know if I know that ticker, unfortunately.
Look at his diamond chain. Look at that symbolism. Look at his diamond chain that I got him. It's literally just a diamond chain that he's showing.
With his diamond hands shirt.
Look at DVFI. That's your sub penny kind of freaking play. And you don't even know the ticker.
That was a huge run.
If ever there was an example for lack of preparation, this is it.
I think that's why I have grown to be a short seller, because the shorting can take, like, you can let these run a day or two and then finally find them. All these like subreddit breaking news plays is probably my weakness that I need to work on, because by the time I find them, they're already up like 100%, you know, and I haven't seen, you know, I gotta be quicker DBFI, with noticing those.
I think DBFI was up like 200% when I did bought it, because it was still up like 200%, but it was off its highs by like 50%. And then it bounced like 40%. So I'm not afraid of these 200, 300, 500% winners if they're moving fast. Like, I have a whole section, I don't know which DVD, about air pockets, and these stocks are just moving on air. Like, they go, you know, today NRPI, I mean, went from 12 to 42 cents in what, like 10 minutes, 15 minutes?
NRPI,
the high was at 9:56 a.m., 45 cents, and at 9:30 was at 11 cents. So four times your money in 20 minutes. Incredible. And then it came all the way back down to 15 cents. And then by day's end, it nearly hit 38 cents, 39 cents. So it nearly doubled off of that. So you just have the volatility. It's crazy bouncing ball volatility.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, but that was the same kind of price action on NRPI, which, you know, they're merging with an aerospace company. So it's not an oil play, but it's the same action as LRDC. You guys, it's not just about partaking in a lot of these plays. It's recognizing. So like, the only reason why I did NRPI so well today is because I had the experience on MDMP and LRDC, and I could recognize, oh, same price action.
Yeah, I didn't trade any of those.
The last two, this is where I know I have to just keep pushing, is that the last two longs I took over, and I actually both of them gapped down on me. So I've been much more in protect mode, because the last two longs I have, unfortunately, not played out well. But of course, there's all plenty of these other longs that are working well. So I need to, like you said, just keep looking at the news that works and try to use those to my advantage versus the ones that I took and then just totally gapped down on me. So,
I mean, do you see TKAT?
Oh God, I haven't even seen any of these stocks.
TKAT was insanity.
NFT crate. Oh, so that's NFT news as well. Jeez.
We've been talking about NFTs for weeks.
I know. Well, that's why I have my NFT long swings, but they're just not the big winners, unfortunately. Did not pick the right ones.
Do you not see CWRK? I mean, this isn't the biggest winner, but this is a beautiful breakout.
Yeah. I was watching that one, but didn't take it either.
It has a history of multi-day runs. It breaks out. It has big volume. Like, it's not the biggest play, but again, like, do you see OCG? Have you guys seen OCG?
OCG, mm-hmm.
Nope.
Jack's like, nope. I haven't seen that one. Nope.
He's too busy polishing his diamond necklace.
No, like, I've not heard any of these tickers at
all. Listen, my point is, you guys deserve a break. It's good to, you know, enjoy your newfound money, you know, get the extra big bottle of Listerine instead of the smaller bottle that you can now afford. Get an extra bottle, give it to a homeless guy, be like, here you go, take care of your teeth, buddy, like, whatever you want to do. But at the same time, keep learning, keep watching this stuff, because I don't know how long this is going to last.
Yeah, I'll be back on the grind soon enough. That's for
sure.
You'll
be back on the grind right now. Look at you. You're eating your are you still having your chef meals?
Oh, you're not gonna like this, Tim.
Not gonna like this. No, he broke my heart.
Why?
Some like really good restaurant hired him. So he's like, I can't cook for you anymore. Cause I'm taking this new job here. So I'm
the
sorry.
Good news is there's hundreds of chefs, and all you have to do is Google. You're like, oh, there's no chefs in my area. I literally spent 35 seconds Googling, and there were like 7 chefs in your area. Your newfound time, since you're not studying the markets and making Excel spreadsheets anymore, now you can search, do whatever you want. Be like, I feel like playing mini golf. Let me Google and see where a mini golf course is near you. Oh, I like skee ball. Let me go play skee ball and try to do it during market hours so you can waste the maximum possible opportunities.
Guilty as charged.
Enjoy your money, but get back on the grind. I have to go. Good talking to you. Get disciplined.
All
Absolutely. Yeah,
thanks for the pep talk, coach.
I think we're just gonna end it there, boys. So if you're new to the show, make sure you like, subscribe. We usually go over charts, but we had Sykes on today, special guest, so we'll be doing that next week. Nothing crazy you're missing anyways. So again, like, subscribe, check the link below. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
Peace.